We have a team of reporters covering some of the hardest hit areas all over Southwest Florida. They've been out there for several hours monitoring the conditions, the flooding, calling their sources, getting you the latest information.
NBC2's Chris Lovingood is in Cape Coral right now. Jesse Pagan in Estero with our NBC2 First Alert Storm Tracker. And Jacqueline Beavis is live in North Fort Myers. Let's begin with NBC2's Chris Lovingood in Cape Coral. Chris, good morning. How are things looking out there?
Morning, Lucas and Stacy. I want to show you the intersection first, still here at Trafalgar Parkway and Chiquita Boulevard. It actually, the water's receding a little bit, and I'm being told from a public works worker that if it does go soon enough, there will be allowed people to coming through this area. But I want to talk water real fast, not the water dropping from the sky, but rather the water you drink. I just talked to a spokesperson with the city of Cape Coral, and she tells me that there is actually people living along Del Prado Boulevard that's north of Hancock, and they have been without water all since yesterday and expected to be without water for the next 10 hours. It says that a contractor bore through one of their 16-inch water mains. We're going to try to figure out who those people are and see how they're being affected today. And we're also being told that the canals are full and they are overflowing. That's why we're seeing this overflowage of water pouring out on a major road that's causing people to find another way to get around Cape Coral. Live in Cape Coral, Chris Lovingood, NBC2.
Chris, thank you. Let's go over to the First Alert Storm Tracker. Jesse Pagan is in Estero for us this morning.
Jesse, what is the latest out by you? You've been looking all up and down that area, seeing a lot.
Yeah, the sides of US 41 seem to be taking a pretty heavy hit to it. Last half hour, we showed you the 10-mile canal that kind of spilled over. Now we're back again a little farther north from that. I want to give you a look behind us so you can go ahead and take a look at what's happening behind us. That's actually someone on a jet ski out on the water right there. This is Island Park Road where we've been at previously this morning, just off US 41. You see that man there just kind of having a time right there. I also want to give you another look over this way a little bit, and you can see a car that's been submerged all throughout the morning. That's been the case with a lot of cars getting stalled on here. Now we're actually going to give you a look in front of us, and we're going to go ahead and get out onto US 41. And so you can see a little bit of what the conditions look like out here. You can take a look and see rain, of course, still coming down and clouding your visibility. A little bit, of course. Roads are slick. We are working to find out from the Lee County Sheriff's Office as well to see if there's any major road closures down here in South Lee County. As soon as I get an answer to that, I'll go ahead and let you know. We do know that we have seen deputies out this morning. We've also seen quite a bit of people patrolling out in their neighborhoods. If you take a look to the right here, this is the 10-mile canal that we were mentioning to you a little bit earlier. Look past some of our equipment and you'll see that water is just taking over this property right here, this RV resort that we are driving past right now. But of course, we are reaching out to sources. We are working out to see what the roads are like and if there's any major road closures that you need to be taking a look at. We are live in South Lee County on the First Alert Storm Tracker. Jesse Pagan, NBC2.
Jesse, thank you. Our team coverage continues with Jacqueline Beavis. She has been canvassing North Fort Myers all morning. Consistent flooding and rain for the last 24 hours.
Now, Jacqueline, you've been out in several different communities this morning. What are you seeing?
Take a look at this. Pine Drop Lane is flooded. This actually, I'll show you, is how people have to get to their houses. They have to walk over this board and actually walk around the side of their home to actually even get there. You can see the road covered in water. Obviously, people living out here are concerned about just how deep it is, about the safety, about what's in this water. They tell me they've alerted the county about just how deep this is. In some places, it goes all the way up to your knees. They tell me yesterday it was even worse. The rain slowed down a bit here right this minute, but we've seen it come and go in North Fort Myers this morning. Again, just a mess here on Pine Drop Lane. Cars have been driving down this road. Definitely a concern, though, and not all of them making it. People out living out here tell me some of their cars stalled out yesterday, and they're waiting for something to get a little bit better out here. Reporting live in North Fort Myers, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.